So we are discussing about instance store. So what is instance store? Instance store means it is local to the instance and it is non-persistent and data not replicated and no snapshot support. So what I am going to do, I am going to connect to this instance. I'm going to connect to this instance. So I'm downloading the remote desktop file. I have the password. I am going to log into the system. So I am going to connect to this instance. I created an instance and I am going to connect to this instance. So using the RDP file, I am going to connect to this instance. I'm giving the username password. So I'm connecting to this instance. So this server, I had ordered an instance store. So what I am saying is, when I go to this my computer, we can see that we have one more disk is here. So when I open this, I'm going to open this D drive because it is an instance store. So I'm going to create some files. I am going to create some file here. So when I save this file, so what I am going to show you is if I save this file here, because it is a instance store, it is not persistent. So what I want to show is, suppose this instance I am going to shut down. So I have saved some file in the D drive is a instance store. So but I am saving something in the C drive. I will create some file. So it will be there when we restart the system. This file will be there. So this file will be there. But when I restart, I want you to see. So this file will not be there. So for that I am going to show. So I am going to select this instance. I am going to stop this instance. So this instance is stopped and I will go to instance state and I will start the instance again. What I am trying to show is, suppose I have a hard disk, I have a volume. This volume is, if I given as instant store, so it is not persistent. So I have created an instance, but this instance I added a instant store. So what we have to know is, when we save some file into this instant store, these files are not persistent. It is not permanent. So when we shut down and start the system, this will go. So I have an instance. I am going to connect to this instance. So I am going to connect to this instance. So what we are going to see is I have two hard disk, two volumes. So I saved some files before. You may be remembering before restarting I had created some files there, but these files are not there, because when we save something in this C drive, so I have saved one file 5 before shutdown. Before shutting down the system, I saved 3 files here, but these files are not there after restart. Suppose I created this file 6, file 7 again. What will happen when I restart this? It will not be there after restart. So that is difference between instance store. We can use this for temporary storage. So we can use for some cache files or temporary files. So this purposes we can use this. So we have to remember this. When we are saving something on this instance store, it will not be permanent. If you are adding this after, when I restart this, when I shut down, if I go and shut down this instance, if I shut down or reboot this instance, after rebooting, these files will not be there after reboot. So that is I am going to explain. So because it is basically a EC2 instance store, so generally we will use elastical block storage. So normal storage is EBS. So we will use EBS storage, but when we use this instance store, it is called ephemeral disk. So we can see that it is using this ephemeral disk. This is local to the host computer, but EBS volume is like a network based storage, and we have S3 buckets are there. And this is called instance store. So whenever we are saving something on this instance store, it is not permanent or it is not persistent. When you reboot the system, so this file will not be there. So if I do reboot, so I have already saved these files here. When I do this rebooting, so when I do reboot or stop and start, this file will go. So that is the difference of this instance store in a EC2 instance. So EC2 instance we have instance store. But generally we have elastic block storage and also we have instance store. So when we created this when we are creating this instance, we selected this MD large, MD5 large. They have the option of instance store option. Volumes are available for this MD5 large. So we can see this. We had seen many topics related to this. And another thing is we can resize the volume. So this volume, the instance is 6F. I have many volumes are there. When I check the volumes, so we have many volumes here. So we can see that which volume is connected to 6F. So we can see that our instance is 6F. So we want to identify which volume is here. So we can see this 30 GB hard disk is connected to this 6F. It is connected to this instance. So we have the option of modifying the volume. So currently we can do this directly. We can do the modify the volume. So we can increase the size to 40, or we can do that. we can directly change this volume. But before, previously, how we are doing is, previously we used to do, we used to create a snapshot for this. So this is connected to DEV SDA 1. So we can, previously what we will do, we used to create a snapshot. So I'm creating a snapshot of that volume. So I used to create a snapshot. We can attach this when it is running. We can attach the volumes. You can do when it is attached. Already changing the size, we have to turn off the system. So I'm creating a snapshot. So currently we can change this directly, but previously what we used to do is we are taking a snapshot of the volume. So we'll try that. If we are asking directly, we can change. We will try that. We will do this after this lab. We will do that. So now currently I am doing to do this. I am taking a snapshot of the volume. So I had taken a snapshot of that volume. So I had identified which volume is connected to that instance. Then I created a snapshot. So what I am going to do, I am going to create a new volume from this snapshot. So I had taken a snapshot from this volume. I am going to create a volume again. So it must be in the same availability zone and all these things. So I am going to the instance. So this instance is in the US West 1A. So I have this snapshot. I'm going to create a volume. So I can change the size now. I can change this volume. So I can change to 50. I can create a new volume, but the data will be same. And I can create a new volume. I can even change this type of this volume. It can be general or it can be magnetic. So we have a different type from there. And I can create a volume. This I changed to 50 GB. So this ending with 91. So I can go to the volumes. So this is ending with 91. So this is the new volume. So I have this new volume and I have the existing volume I have to remove. So we will check that. I will check the instance. So the instance is ending with 6F. I will check the old volume. So it is attached to this 6F. So this is DVVSDA1. So this is my old volume. So I am going to detach this. So this is GB, 50 GB I want to attach again. I'm going to attach this. So I'm going to attach to this. Going to give us DVSDA1. So now I will try to start the instance. going to connect to that instance. So we can see that the size is changed. So this size seems changed. Maybe we'll check. So if this size is showing here, what I can do is I can extend the volume. So if the size is showing there, but what I can do is I can do this, extend the volume. So previously it was 30 GB. I extended it to 50 GB. It is showing like a 50 GB. So it is showing now 50 GB. Now we will try whether we can extend it online. So this volume, new volume is, so the new volume is ending with 891. So I will check the volume. So this is 891. So I want to modify this. I want to make it as 70 GB. I want to modify this as 70 GB. So it is showing 70 GB here. So I will start disk management. So we can see this space is here. So directly we can extend this. So when going to my computer, it is showing us 70 GB here. So we can do this, extending the volume. We can do like this. So we are saying we can add additional volumes, we can add to an instance, and we can add, like we are adding like this instance. So that is one important thing. So we are adding an instance like instance store type. So there are we are generally using EBS, Elastic Block Storage, and we have another storage called instance store. When we are adding a volume that is of this category, that is of instance store category, that means that they are saying that instance store is local to the host computer. Host machine is the main system that is having hypervisor everything. So we are creating instances on that hypervisor. So this is connected to the EBS volume. EBS volume is the normally the hard disk like C drive and all we are using, D drives and all. We will use instance like that is all EBS, that is persistent. But when we are storing something to instance store, that is not persistent, that we have to know. We have one more storage called EFS. We'll do another session. It is a shared storage for multiple instance. EFS, one more volume is there, storage is there. And we had seen about S3. S3 storage we had seen. So we know that how to create S3 storage. So what we snapshot we can create. Volume, whenever they're running, we can create the snapshot. So snapshot, it will be point in time backup of this backup. That we can do that. And we have S3 storage. We had seen about S3 storage. But I stopped it, but it was already stopped or like that. So I did not, I can do right now also I can do. So they will have charges for when you are taking in backups, they have charges. So we have we know this which is the volume. So the new volume is ending with 891. So I can go to this volumes. So it is ending with 891 and it is attached to this CF6F. So I can take the snapshot even instance is running. So I can take the snapshot, it will work. Because we do generally, people will do automated backups. So we can do that. But in Linux, when we are extending the volume, so we have different commands for that, extending the volume. We have to do the commands for extending that. Maybe ext2 online or resize commands are there. So there are different storages. One is EBS, Elastic Block Storage. Another one is Instance Store or Ephemeral Disk Volume. And we have this S3 storage. So what is the difference? EBS is generally a block level storage. Block level means we can install operating system and everything. But S3 is also we can store the content, but it is object storage. So we are storing a file, complete file we are storing. If you want to replace the file, we have to replace the complete file. So we had seen this S3. S3 is a different storage. Here we can store files. It is called object storage because it is like a complete file we are storing. We want to change the file means we are changing. Suppose we want to update a new file. We have to change the complete file. But in the case of block level storage, we are changing only that block. So we can install operating system in EBS volume, But S3, we cannot install operating system. S3 is for object storage. So we had seen this properties of different classes are there. So we have different classes. So when we go there, we can see the properties. So we have S3 also, we have different storage classes. S3 we have different classes, standard infrequent access, one zone infrequent access, and reduced redundancy. So if you want to store in with less cost, we can use another option, standard IA. Standard is more costly, we can use less options. And we have one more option called Glacier. Glacier is mainly for the archiving. So we want to archive the file, we can use this. When you go to properties, so when we go to the management tab, we can do lifecycle management. So what we can do is, we can say that we want to archive this files. So we can add a lifecycle rule. So we are adding a lifecycle rule. We are adding current version or previous version. And we can add a transition. So we can say that this want to move to Glacier after 10 days or after 5 days, we want to move this to Glacier. We can configure like this. So it will go to this Glacier. Glacier is means like a archiving for backup purpose. So we can do that. We can move to Glacier. Can add a lifecycle rule. We are saying that current version. We can add a transition rule. We can say that after move to Glacier after one day or 2 days. We can change it like that. So we can do expiration. So after 360 days, we want to delete this file. So we can do this expiration. And we can do create a rule. So we have the option of initiate restore. Suppose if this is in Glacier, we have this option of initiate restore option is there.